Hello, my name is Caleb, and I wanted to take a few minutes this afternoon to show you some techniques to use the CellScale MicroSquisher system with some microspheres of hydrogels. So just to introduce you to how to use it and how it works, I have some samples here, and I got the system all set up to go. So just a short video to introduce that. Right here I've got my test chamber, and I'm going to take some spheres, which are in this vial here, use a pipette, get some on my syringe, or in my pipetter, and I'll bring these in here. And then you'll see I just dropped a couple into the chamber. So on the screen here, there's one here. Just happened to fall right in the middle of the screen, but if I move the camera back and forth, I actually did drop in a few of them there, and they're sitting on that lower fixed surface in the system. So next thing I'll do, while I'm still at low zoom, is I'm going to bring over the top of the beam here. So bring it over. Maybe I'll just, where it might be out of the frame vertically actually. Oh, here it is. Okay. And I'll bring that down to roughly the right position. And then I'll fix my optics on a suitable zoom level. And move them around so I can see exactly what I want to see in the middle of the frame. And slowing down the jog, then I'll just slowly bring the moving surface so that it just about touches but doesn't quite touch. You can see it's jiggling back and forth there. So that just with the as I touch the table, you can see I'm making the gel move and just sit there. So it's not under any load right there at all. I've set the zoom to 3, and if I move the crosshairs then on the top and bottom of the specimen, that you will fix the specimen size, which in this case is 871 micrometers. I've set up my test protocol to do 400 micrometers of displacement in 30 seconds. So I'll just select a tracking point that's part of the moving surface and start the test. And you'll see we're coming in here to do a compression. Force versus time, displacement versus time, and force versus displacement. This is a relatively large microsphere, so we're expecting forces into the millinewton range, and that's what we're getting. We're hitting about 2 millinewtons there now, coming up on 3 millinewtons. And you see that the sphere, what was once a sphere, now has the flattened surfaces due to the compression. And that's the end of the test. And the software then allows me to go in and review this test. If I can find it here. I think it's this one here, and I can then do a playback and start to look at the forces in real time as I maybe speed that up a bit, so that I can. I'll just run that really fast here so we can see that. So there's what's happening. While I'm doing the compression, you're seeing the forces ramp up. Anyway, thanks very much for watching this. I just wanted to, we've had a number of requests for people doing this kind of work, and I wanted to kind of demonstrate how it's done. But if you have further questions or want to have some sample testing on your particular materials, by all means, let me know. Appreciate it. Thanks.